So this question got a lot of attention on the internet. And if you apply the order of operations that you would have learned in primary school, which is usually called something like PEMDAS or BODMAS or BIDMAS or BEDMAS, depending on what country you're in, you would get the answer of 9. But here's the thing.
PEMDAS is a lie.
PEMDAS is an oversimplification that we teach to children to make things easy. It's like saying that negative numbers don't have square roots. We just want to get on with the lesson. But PEMDAS isn't the way that mathematicians, physicists, or engineers actually evaluate mathematical expressions. I'll talk about the real rule in a minute, but first let's see how PEMDAS applies to our question.
So what you need to understand about the order of operations, as they teach it in primary school, is that multiplication and division have equal precedence. So I'm just going to write PEMDAS like that to show that it's just 4 things: parentheses, exponents, multiplication and division in whatever order they occur from left to right, and then addition and subtraction in whatever order they occur. So with this question, we start with what's inside the parentheses, the 1 plus 2, that makes 3. And then there's no exponents. We move on to multiplication and division in the order they occur. So we've got a division there and a multiplication there. This one's to the left, so that one happens first. So you do the 6 divided by 2, and that makes 3. And then that's multiplied by the 3. So now we do that, and that makes 9. So let's see how the order of operations applies to something like A slash BC. So again, we've got a division and a multiplication. We start on the left. So A divided by B is the first thing you do, and then you multiply the result of that by C. So this, according to PEMDAS, is the same as A over B times C. But is that how mathematicians, scientists, and engineers would actually interpret this expression? So to test this out, I just Googled mathematics textbook PDF, and this is the first one that I clicked on. This is Abstract Algebra by Robert B. Ash. And you can see on the second page of the PDF, I just went straight to the answers to exercises because that's where I was expecting to find expressions like this. So we've got this. What they've done to get that is multiplied the m over r by n over s. So that would make mn over rs. And then they've written it like that, though. Whereas the order of operations would tell you that that means mn divided by r, the division comes first, and then you would multiply by the s. And that, of course, makes mns over r. But they're using it to mean that, so they're obviously not using the order of operations as it's taught in primary school. What about physics? This is from the Feynman lectures on physics. We've got a deviation of 1 on 2 root n. And then they've written that, again, down here, in line, as 1 slash 2 root n. Now, order of operations would say that that means half root n. But they're using it to mean 1 on 2 root n. So they're doing the multiplication first, before the division. What about engineering? I've just Googled engineering textbook PDF, and this was the first one that I clicked on. This is on page 15. I'll put a link to it in the description. But what they've done is they've solved these equations for W and got PVmg on RT. And then they've written that like this, with a slash RT. And PEMDAS would say that that means PVmg divided by R, and then you would multiply by T. And that is not the same thing as that. So they're not using PEMDAS. So the textbook authors aren't following PEMDAS, but what do the students think? Well, Oliver Nill of Harvard asked his calculus students this question. What is 2x over 3y minus 1 if x equals 9 and y equals 2? Well, according to PEMDAS, you would say 2 times 9 divided by 3 times 2 minus 1. 2 times 9 is 18, then you divide by 3, that makes 6, you multiply by 2, that makes 12, and then you subtract 1, that's 11. And this is what this fifth grade teacher was saying. they asked their students this question, and it caused a bit of a stir because the parents and students didn't agree. So anyway, Oliver Nil asks his calculus class this question, and 58 out of 60 of them said, no, it's 2 times 9 over 3 times 2, and then you subtract 1. So that's 18 over 6, which is 3, and then minus 1 makes 2. 58 out of 60 said that. The two that didn't, interestingly, didn't say 11. They did 2 times 9 over 3 times 2 and put the minus 1 in the denominator as well. So absolutely nobody would interpret the question like that. It's easy to see why this became a rule. If you want to write something like 1 over 2x in one line, you would have to use brackets, which is annoying. So mathematicians tend to be quite lazy and they just write 1 slash 2x when they mean 1 over 2x. Now, the order of operations that you would learn in school says that this is the same as half of x. But there's a much easier way of writing this. You could just say x over 2. So people have developed this rule that 1 slash 2x means 1 over 2x, and if you want to write half x, you just write x over 2. So it's an unofficial rule that's used by almost everyone in math, science, and engineering. But has it ever been an official rule? Well, indeed it has. This is from a style guide put out by the American Mathematical Society. And here they clearly say that they use the rule that multiplication indicated by juxtaposition is carried out before division. And here they're just saying that if you write something like 1 over 2 pi I, they're going to change it to 1 slash 2 pi I, and that these mean the same thing. Likewise, the American Physical Society, in their style guide, say, in mathematical formulas, this is the accepted order of operations: raising to a power, then multiplication, and then division, and then addition and subtraction have equal precedence. So how does this rule apply to our question? Well, you still start by evaluating what's in the parentheses. That makes 3. But then multiplication by juxtaposition comes before division. So we've got 6 divided by 6, which makes 1. So although PEMDAS says that the answer to this is 9, no one actually uses PEMDAS after primary school.
Let me know in the comments if your teacher ever told you that PEMDAS isn't the whole truth. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, then subscribe, because there's lots more coming up about the how and why of mathematics.